Good evening, and welcome to the Delta Gamma teaching series. Today we're going to start logarithms. In our previous discussions, when we discussed indices, I said indices and logarithms are close cousins. Now, I likened the two to a journalist interviewing a person and asking the same question in two ways. So logarithms and indices are like a journalist asking the same question in two ways. For instance, in indices, we say that a raised to the power n is equal to a given number. Yeah? But then in logarithms, we say what power must a base be raised to give a certain number. It's the same thing put in different ways. Yeah. Now we learn from indices that a raised to the power n times a raised to the power m is equal to a raised to the power n plus m, and then a raised to the power n divided by a raised to the power m is equal to a raised to the power n minus m. We deduce all these things, so I don't need to go back, but you can see them. Now, logarithms, in logarithms, we see that if a raised to the power n is equal to b in logarithms and a raised to the power m is equal to c, then log b to the base a, yeah, is equal to log of a raised to the power n to the base a. Because we say here b is equal to a raised to the power n. So if you replace b by a raised to the power n here, we get log of a raised to the power n to the base a, and that is equal to n. Hence, we can say that if a raised to the power n is equal to b, then log of b to the base a is equal to n. Likewise, log of c to the base a, if we substitute c by a raised to the power m, then log of c to the base a becomes log of a raised to the power m to the base a, which is equal to m. Now let's look at this situation now, where you have log of into brackets b times c to the base a. Now b is replaced by a raised to the power n, because we define b is equal to a raised to the power n here, and c is replaced by a raised to the power m, because we said c is equal to a raised to the power m here. So by the law of indices, these two becomes a raised to the power n plus n. Now, so we have a raised to the power into brackets n plus m to the base a, and that is equal to n plus m. But from here, this equation 1, we found that n is equal to log of b to the base a. Yeah? And from equation 2, we found that m is equal to log of c to the base a. So if you replace that, then we get log of b times c is equal to log of b to the base a plus log of c to the base a. That is our equation 3 now. So in general, log of b times c to the base a is equal to log of b to the base a plus log of c to the base a. So that's one beauty. And likewise, let me come. Log of into bracket b divided by c to the base a becomes log of A raised to the power n. Divided by a raised to the power m, which is equal to log of to the base a. This a of a raised to the power n minus m, which is equal to n minus m. Now, inferring from equation 1 and 2 before, n is equal to log of b to the base a, and m is equal to log of c to the base a. Therefore, in general, log of b divided by c to the base a is equal to log of b to the base a minus log of c to the base a. So this is another general equation in logarithms. Yeah? Now, let's consider a situation where we have let's consider another situation where we have, say, consider this situation where we have, say, consider b raised to the power n. That will be equal to a raised to the power n all raised to the power m, and that is equal to a raised to the power n m. Therefore, which would imply that log of b raised to the power m to the base a would be equivalent to log of a raised to the power n m to the base a, which is equal to n m. But n is equal to log of b to the base a. Yeah? From equation 1. This implies that log of b raised to the power m to the base a is equal to n m, which is equal to log b to the power a times m, which is equal to m log b to the power a. Therefore, in general, log of any number b raised to the power n to the base a is equal to n log b to the base A. That is also another generalization of logarithms. So these are important things to know in logarithms, and then you can apply them in solving so many problems. Thank you for listening today. We shall continue logarithms in our next meeting.